had it not been for the Cuban presence in Africa, and in particular in Angola, the history of Africa would have never been what it is now. One of the greatest friends that Cuba has is Nelson Mandela, and his appreciation for what the Cuban people did, and Fidel Castro. But I think if you don't understand that history, then you'll never really understand the enormous success and the importance of the Cuban Revolution.
Well, my president. My president.
My brother.
Presidente, my brother.
How are you?
My brother.
Please. Please. Very nice to see you.
Tan contento de verlo.
Please sit down.
Tan contento. Por favor, tenga bien sentarse.
Please sit down.
Siéntese.
Now, one thing before we say anything.
Una cosa antes de hablar, nada, nada.
Before we say anything.
Antes de hablar absolutamente de cualquier tema.
You must tell me when you are coming to South Africa.
Me tiene que decir cuándo viene para Sudáfrica.
Yo sé,
no,
seguro, si ya yo recibí.
The sooner the better.
And we have had a visitor from a wide variety of people.
Una gran cantidad de personas.
And our friend Cuba.
Y nuestro amigo Cuba.
Which helped us in training our people.
Que nos ayudó a entrenar a nuestra gente.
Gave us resources to get on with our struggle.
Que nos ayudaron tanto nuestra
trained
lucha,
our people as doctors and so on.
A nuestros médicos.
You have not come to our country.
Cuba no ha venido a visitarnos. Usted no ha ido a visitarnos.
When are you coming?
¿Cuándo viene?
No he visitado a mi patria surafricana.
I haven't visited my South African homeland
la
yet.
La quiero como una patria.
I want it, I love it as
quiero
a homeland.
Y por el pueblo
I love it as a homeland as I love you and the South African people.
When are you coming to South Africa?
Pero ¿cuándo viene a Sudáfrica?
Creo que va a tener que ser hoy mismo. Va a tener
I think it will have to be today. I will have to fly back with you.
No, you are very, very, very sure.
Se va a las 10.
You are leaving at 10, so we are catching the plane together.
Poco después, Fidel sí pudo ir a Sudáfrica. Y en el camino hizo escala en Namibia, donde fue recibido por Sandu Njoma, el líder de ese país.
Welcome to the Republic of Namibia.
Bienvenido a la República de Namibia.
The country which you helped to reparate, to be reparated.
En Sudáfrica, Mandela lo esperaba. Fidel fue invitado a hablar al Parlamento sudafricano.
Conviértase Sudáfrica en modelo de un mundo futuro más justo y más humano.
Let South Africa be a model of a more just and more humane future.
Si ustedes pueden, todos podemos.
If you can do it, we will all be able to do it.
Fidel's link to the post-colonial era as the figure who more than any, I think, symbolizes independence and sovereignty of small nations, shaking off the yoke of the imperial powers, and the fact that he has been there for as long as he has and has been able to magnify his role to really a global force from this tiny island base.
It is easy to build a nation.
it is far more difficult to shape a society. And this is what Cuba is doing. It will need all the time in the world. It will need all the humility, all the meekness, all the generosity of spirit to itself and to others to emerge.
En los años 70 y 80, el campo de batalla interno era la economía. Se hacían grandes esfuerzos para industrializar el país y crear un bienestar compartido pese al bloqueo de los Estados Unidos. Cuba dependía de un solo cultivo, el azúcar. La Unión Soviética había prometido comprar toda la producción. Fidel animaba al resto del país en el intento de alcanzar cosechas récord.
Conseguir de su desarrollo es una tarea titánica, realmente. Y salir del subdesarrollo en las condiciones de Cuba todavía más bloqueada por Estados Unidos.
Ya que para la independencia de Cuba era esencial el apoyo de la Unión Soviética, Fidel se balanceaba en una situación que duró alrededor de 30 años. La ayuda de la Unión Soviética hizo posible que Cuba mantuviera sus avances en educación, salud, promoción del deporte y el desarrollo científico, así como una mayor diversificación industrial.
The government of Fidel Castro has shown a world that is teeming with billions of impoverished people that it is possible for a very poor country emerging from sickness and ignorance and corruption and poverty of a Batista regime to within a few short years educate all of its children. To create a system of education that is comprehensive, that reaches the entire society, that abolishes illiteracy.